After 9 years of producing instructional videos, one of the most requested topics over the years has been the subject of VPNs. For those of you who are not familiar with the term, VPN stands for Virtual Private Network. It's a type of service that allows you to disguise your location to make it look like you're coming from somewhere else. People use VPNs for a wide variety of reasons. Whatever your reason is, my hope is that this video acts as a resource and answers a lot of the questions that consumers tend to have about this very complicated subject. Let's have a talk about VPNs, coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hello everyone and welcome to the class. Today we are talking all about VPNs, and one of the most important things that you should know about this subject is that there is a ton of bad information on the internet about this topic, and signing up with the wrong VPN can have really dire consequences, including identity theft. Joining me once again for today's discussion is Thomas Reed, who is the Director of Mac and Mobile Security at Malwarebytes. Thomas, thank you so much for joining me once again.
Hi, thanks, David. It's good to be here.
Thomas, we got a great response from our last video, which, just in case any of you missed it, was all about the subject of adware and malware on the Mac. And today we are continuing that discussion, but focusing in on the subject of VPNs because this is a complicated subject. Today's video is sponsored by our friends at Malwarebytes, and if you've watched my channel over the years, you're probably aware that I have been recommending Malwarebytes products for years, including well before they sponsored my YouTube channel. So I would like to thank them for sponsoring today's video. Thomas, of all of the research that I have done on this topic, one of the most important things that I think needs to be discussed right at the very beginning is the importance of knowing what country your VPN service is based out of. Would you agree with that statement? And if so, could you elaborate and tell us why is that information so important?
Absolutely. I think the country is very important for a VPN. And that's mostly due to the laws that are on the books in those countries. So some countries have very privacy poor laws on their books. They can require VPN providers to log data that you don't want them to be logging and that they turn it over to the government. Other countries are very strong on privacy protections within their legal systems. And in those countries, a VPN provider is not required to log data that you don't want logged and isn't going to be required to turn over data that they don't have to the government. So you definitely want to have a VPN that's run out of a more privacy-focused country.
Why are VPNs necessary?
VPNs are important for two reasons. One of those is security, and the other one is privacy. So on the security side, a VPN essentially forms a secure tunnel through which all of your data travels. And this is particularly important if you're somewhere like on an open Wi-Fi network, like say at your neighborhood coffee shop or somewhere like that. You want that tunnel to protect your data against someone sitting at the next table who could be snooping on your network data as it goes through the wireless network. As far as privacy goes, a VPN is a very good tool for masking your location, which is a big part of your identity online.
So the next obvious question is, if you decide to sign up for a VPN service, is this the kind of thing that you should use all the time, or just when accessing certain websites or services?
I would say that you absolutely want to use it all the time when you're on any kind of public Wi-Fi, any Wi-Fi that you or your employer are not in control of. So if you're at the airport, if you are, you know, on public Wi-Fi in any other location, you definitely want that to protect yourself against someone else that's on the network, or potentially even the owner of the network who could be capturing your data. When you're at home, that's another story. So some people still like to use a VPN at home because it protects their privacy against their own internet service provider. Internet service providers actually collect a lot of data about you, and they can see that data because it's flowing right through their systems. So if you have concerns about the data your internet service provider might be collecting on you, use a VPN, and that protects all of your traffic against snooping by your internet service provider.
So let's say you are in a cafe. Is it better to use a VPN, or could you potentially just use your cellular data instead?
Contrary to what some people believe, your cellular data is actually fairly secure. It's much more secure than Wi-Fi because it's harder to snoop on cellular data. That's not to say it's impossible, of course, but it's definitely above the level of some fairly low-level hacker with a laptop in a coffee shop who can just, you know, monitor the Wi-Fi. I think that the biggest question there is, how much data do you have through your cell provider, and how fast is it? If you're on a fairly unlimited plan that doesn't have any kind of a bandwidth cap, maybe that's a good solution for you. For most people though, a VPN on the Wi-Fi will actually be faster, and it won't cost you overages due to, you know, downloading too much through your cellular data.
How effective are browser-based VPNs?
There are a number of VPNs that work through a browser extension or a feature within a browser, and those can be very helpful for certain situations, but the biggest problem with those VPNs is that they are browser-based. So yes, they protect your traffic within that specific web browser, but any other traffic outside your web browser is not protected by the VPN. And that's something that's not always clear to some people. They think that once they've turned on the VPN in their browser, that everything is protected. But behind the scenes, you know, they've got their mail client sending and receiving data outside the browser. They may have, say, the calendar app on Mac OS or iOS. That's going to be sending and receiving data outside the browser. So you have all these different services on your computer that are separate from the browser, and those can only be protected by something that is covering the entire computer, not just the browser.
Thomas, before we did this video, I jumped on YouTube Live from underneath my grapefruit tree and asked people what were their big questions that they had about VPN services. And one of the biggest questions that we got is we got a lot of people saying that when they were using their VPN, they couldn't access certain services. In some cases, it was email. In other cases, it was Netflix. In other cases, it was certain websites. Why is that?
So there are a lot of services out there that don't like you using a VPN to access their service. So these are often things like streaming services that may have differences in what they're able to offer, either legally or for whatever other reason, in different countries. And so if you're trying to connect, say, to Netflix or Hulu or one of these other streaming services from a country that they don't support or something like that, you're probably going to be using a VPN for that. And so they will do their best to prevent you from doing that. The same can be true of something like, say, your bank site. If you connect to your bank site from home, and let's say that you live in California, and then you connect to your VPN and you connect to your bank site again, not too long later, and suddenly it looks like you are in France. Your bank is gonna say, wait, what's going on here? Why, you didn't just suddenly teleport all the way over to France. And so that's going to be a trigger that's gonna make them not support that connection. And some may actually directly block VPN connections altogether. So when that happens, there's not really a whole lot that you can do about it. These providers will either support a VPN or they will block it. If it is one that does not allow you to connect through a VPN, your only option is to turn off the VPN while you're talking to that service. Or if your VPN supports it, you can actually sort of punch a hole through the VPN for just that one particular service.
Which VPNs are legit and which ones are really just using your data?
Well, if you've ever heard the saying that if you're not paying for a service, you're not the customer, you're the product, there are fewer places where that's more true than with free VPNs. A VPN is not something that is a cheap service to run. They have a fairly hefty price tag on the back end, especially if you get good speeds and you know, lots of different countries that you can connect through. So it's none of that is cheap. And so if a VPN provider is offering you those kinds of services for free, there's really only one reason for that, and that is they're using your data. They're monetizing your data. And you don't know exactly what they're doing with your data. You don't know who they're selling it to. So those are definitely services I recommend to stay away from. You always, with a VPN, want to pay for the service and ensure that you've reviewed what that VPN does with your data and that you're comfortable with it.
Another question that we heard from a lot of people is, are VPNs slow and why?
That's a very common question, and there's definitely some truth to the question about whether or not a VPN can cause a performance problem with your network. Depending on the VPN, depending on where you're connecting through, there definitely can be speed issues. For example, if you are in New York City and you're connecting through a server that is in Australia, then you try and visit a website that's in California, well, your network data has to go from New York to Australia, then back to California, and that introduces some lag. Now, every VPN is a little bit different in terms of the performance they're able to offer, and so, for some, that performance impact is fairly significant. You know, you're paying a price in terms of speed for the privacy and security you get. And for other VPNs, that performance decrease is pretty negligible. You wouldn't even notice it in the course of your day-to-day browsing.
Should you use a VPN on your phone?
Absolutely. I actually will use a VPN on my phone more often than I do on my laptop. You know, on my laptop, I can turn off Wi-Fi a lot of the time and use it if I'm in the airport or, you know, other places like that. And unless I really need something on the network, I can just keep the Wi-Fi turned off. But my phone is always connected, no matter where I go, and I'm constantly moving around with it. And if you've ever tried to manage the wireless networks on your iPhone, especially on an iPhone, you may have noticed that if you're not in the presence of a network, you can't delete it. So that means that you've got all these remembered Wi-Fi networks in your phone that you're probably constantly connecting to without you even remembering or knowing. And so as you're moving around like that, you definitely want to have a VPN on that's protecting you against all those different networks you might be inadvertently connecting to.
So when we're talking about VPNs, obviously the subject of privacy laws is bound to come up. And privacy laws can be very different depending on what country we're talking about. So let me just ask you this, Thomas. What country, in your opinion, is best when it comes to protecting consumers' privacy?
You know, there's no easy single answer because certain countries may be stronger in some areas than others. However, in general, I can say that from my perspective, Sweden does a very good job with their privacy laws. And if you're using a VPN based out of Sweden, you really can't go wrong.
So one of the things I think a lot of consumers have questions about is, do I need a VPN? So can you tell us about what are the totally legitimate reasons where someone would absolutely want to consider having a VPN?
Absolutely. You know, that's one of the things I hear almost all the time from people is, I don't have anything to hide. Why should I need to worry about a VPN? And that's probably true from a legal perspective. You know, you don't have to be running from the law to use a VPN. However, everyone has data that they don't want to get into the wrong hands. You may have, you know, a medical condition that you wouldn't want your insurance company to find out about or your employer to find out about. You may have, financial information that you would really rather keep to yourself and you don't want just some stranger in a coffee shop being able to pick that up. And, you know, with any of this kind of data, privacy is really key, and it's really the foundation to security on the internet for the most part. You know, if your data is visible, it's really not secure. It's not only not private, but it's not secure either.
So everyone wants to know the answer to the question, what is the best VPN service out there? And we've kind of already said that the best country for privacy protection is Sweden. Obviously, we want a service that has good speed. So Thomas, tell us, what do you think is the best VPN service out there? And just a heads up, I agree with what Thomas is going to say. Take it away.
So my recommendation, and this is not just because I am an employee of Malwarebytes, is the Malwarebytes Privacy VPN. We have managed to provide very, very good speeds. You know, they're very high speeds. Some of the best privacy in the industry, with absolutely no logging. We really don't want to know anything. You know, we're not collecting any data. And really amazing security on top of all of that. That's got my vote, not just because I'm an employee, but also as a consumer myself.
If you've watched my videos over the years, you are probably aware that anytime I collaborate with a brand, I always try to negotiate some sort of a discount to pass on to all of you at home. Now, sometimes I'm able to save you 10 or even 15%, but this deal is way better than that. If you were to go to Malwarebytes' website and purchase only their normal product for 5 devices to protect your computer against spyware, malware, and adware, you would be paying $80 a year. If you purchased only the Privacy VPN, you'd be paying $60 a year. But get ready for this. If you use my link down below in the video description, you can get both for $75 a year. So you're basically just paying for the Malwarebytes product and you get the Privacy VPN for free. And again, that includes licenses for 5 devices, so you can share them with other members of your family. Before we go, I wanted to share some final thoughts. Not everyone may need a VPN for their computer, but I would like to re-emphasize something that Thomas said earlier. One of the big problems with the iPhone is that there is no way to manage the networks that your phone connects to. So, for example, if I'm walking through a downtown area, the phone in my pocket is actively searching for familiar networks and trying to connect to them. If someone were to tap into one of those networks, or even worse, if they were to recreate one of them and then just have the exact same security protocols, they could easily tap into my phone without my ever even knowing about it. And for that reason alone, I think it's a really good idea to have a VPN available on your mobile device that you can turn on or off as needed. One quick note, Malwarebytes Privacy VPN is currently available for both Mac and Windows and will launch on iOS and Android as of spring 2021. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.